My name is Jeff Kysar, and I've been at Columbia now for 3.5 years. And my research topics deal mainly with trying to understand the mechanical behavior of materials at what we call the micron length scale and also the nanometer length scale. It is the defects in the materials which often give rise to the most important and interesting properties. And so one of the things I do then in my research is to grow crystals of different materials. So we can do experiments of deformation processes on single crystals like this. And from that, we can get direct information about the deformation and the fatigue life of single crystals which are used in industry. That is a very hot topic. For example, the Department of Energy is very interested in understanding how materials deform under very severe environments. For example, materials that are used in the construction of nuclear power plants, with time, these materials become much more brittle. So some of my research is simply a theoretical analysis to understand under what conditions a material is ductile and under what conditions it's brittle, and what causes that transition. Now, another way of looking at the properties of materials is to look at the behavior of small voids in a material. The Department of Defense is interested in this, for example, because when armor suffers a hit, then the stress wave travels through the armor, and many of these small voids then are generated upon the reflection of this stress wave from the interior surface. And that is actually what often causes the material failure to occur. So it's a fundamental concern to understand the stresses and the deformation state around one of these voids. Well, in a crystal like this, what we do is we first orient our single crystal so that when we apply a loading to it, that all of the deformation occurs only in one plane. And that then makes the analysis much simpler, even though it's still a legitimate deformation state. What we do then is we use an electric discharge machine, which we have in our laboratory, and we slice the crystal open so that we expose one of these surfaces which suffered this plane deformation state. And then we go to a scanning electron microscope and we use an attachment which is called an electron backscatter diffraction, and we obtain a picture of what the crystallographic orientation is after deformation. And we also know what it is before deformation because it's a single crystal. The crystallographic orientation was the same everywhere. So in that sense, then, we can measure directly how much the material has rotated during the deformation. These are really some of the first experimental results in which one obtains what is known as a heterogeneous deformation state. That means that the deformation changes as a function of position. Hopefully it will be able to provide a baseline against which the computer simulations and analytical theories which attempt to model these processes can be winnowed out, so to speak. We do some of the same type of indentation experiments. We use the same type of experimental setup, but we use a wedge to indent a material. And the crystallographic orientation of the discontinuity shown here is exactly the same as the crystallographic orientation of the discontinuity associated with void growth. And we also see the same type of discontinuity at a crack tip in a single crystal. These were the first pictures of deformation under an indentation which have ever been made. Another line of research that I'm involved heavily in collaboration with Professor Jim Hone in our department, and also Professor Chi-Wei Wong in our department, is to test the mechanical properties of materials at the nanometer length scale. And in this case, we've taken a single crystal of gold and we've deposited it onto a silicon wafer, and then we've managed to etch out these individual tensile test specimens. So we're able to go in then and measure the mechanical properties at these very small length scales. And again, this is at the forefront of research in plasticity in the sense that there are at most one or two other groups in the world who are have the expertise and the facilities available to make these types of specimens as well as to test them. Many of the applications of this are toward understanding material behavior better so that we can design new materials which are more resistant to fatigue failure, to cracking, to deformation of all types. So that's the main topics of my research.